Tina, we're getting to the end of Download Festival, and I've had the pleasure of being joined by Whitfield Crane from Ugly Kid Joe. How you doing, Whit?
I'm so happy. It's awesome.
I'm not surprised you're happy. Your set was absolutely brilliant. You got everyone going. Sun was shining. How did it feel for you?
Awesome. Great. It's 10-year anniversary, right, of this show. I grew up, I heard all about Monsters of Rock. We've heard all about this place. I've never been here, you know, and I would come here just to see the bands. I saw Metallica last night, you know, I saw Anthrax today. Megadeth's playing right now. So I, as a fan, would be here, let alone get to play. So how am I doing? I'm doing all right.
Well, that's great. Well, it has been, I mean, last time I saw you in the UK was 19 years ago, giving my age away now. Don Valley Stadium in Sheffield with Def Leppard.
That was 19 years ago to the day, June 6th.
Yep. And I saw you 19 years later at the Underworld on June the 6th, 2012.
Today, June 10th? Today, right now?
Yeah.
So 4 days ago, we played London. We're living a lot of life real fast. It's good. Isn't that weird?
Yeah. Fantastic.
Yeah.
So why does it take you so long to come back, sort things out?
That's a long answer. I know that Klaus was over it. When the band was done, it was done. No, you know, nothing ends well. Nothing, you know, that I can think of. Marriages don't, bands don't, jobs don't. It was over. The luxury I had with Klaus, the guitar player, is that we grew up together. So we love each other from a friendship area. So when the band was done, we went back to being friends. I would ask him periodically, though. I'd say, hey, man. And the answer was no. No way, no chance. And then for whatever reason, like about a year or two ago, the guitar player Dave Fortman and the drummer Shannon Larkin, who were making music right at the moment, called Klaus. And both those guys are at the top of their game. Dave's a Magus producer. Shannon, of course, is in Godsmack. So those guys called Klaus and said, let's make some music. And since it came through them, came from them, for whatever reason it was palatable for Klaus, and of course me, my answer is yes. Do you want to sing? Do you want to sing some songs? Yes, of course. That's a nutshell answer.
Excellent. And I noticed there were no stage antics this time around.
I was told no climbing or they turn me off.
No.
Flat out. Live Nation said, and funny enough, 20 years ago, I would have done it anyway.
I think I watched you do it 20 years ago.
Oh, yeah. I was doing whatever I do in Sweden the other night, and my tour manager Luke came in and said, hey man, like, what's up Luke? He has a big gnarly beard, he's awesome. He was doing sound check. You see him singing today?
Well, unfortunately I missed the very start of your set, but
he looked me straight in the face and said, if you climb anything tonight, they'll turn you off, flat out. And I said, oh, okay, then I won't do it. Which was really, I don't know if it's an evolved answer, but I was like, all right, I want to play, you know? If they turned us off, that would have sucked. But no antics allowed. There was the enemy of fun.
It was a great show. Great show. Absolutely great show. Didn't sort of distract.
Didn't matter.
No, it didn't matter.
I agree.
So, new EP.
Yeah. New EP, 6 songs, Stairway to Hell, All Killer, No Filler. It's good. We're really proud of it. We're really excited about a lot of different things. The music is better than ever for whatever reason. You know, everyone wanted to be in the room when we created it. There is no label. There is no manager. There's just us wanting it. Equally, the artwork that is manifested. Awesome. Like, we made this is an actual Motorhead shirt, but we made an Ugly Kid Joe Motorhead shirt where it says Ugly, it looks like this, exactly. It says Ugly Kid Joe, it says California, and it's Ugly Kid Joe eating this thing. And it's awesome. And it says Ugly Kid Joe, on the back it says everything uglier than everything else. And we asked Motorhead, is this cool? And they said, yes.
Why? Because I was going to ask you that, because I noticed when you're on stage that you're wearing the Motorhead shirt, and I saw the other shirts at the Underworld.
We said, we got this great art, what do you think? And once again, I could call Todd Singerman, the manager, who I love, and he loves me. What do you think about this idea? Which is pretty bold. And he's all, we like the idea, they're honored, why don't you go and do it for this run? Don't sell it, you know, digitally or whatever, but go ahead and do that if it makes you feel good. And Lemmy was honored, he liked it.
Like, I have to say, what was a really refreshing to see on Wednesday night, I haven't seen the merch stands here, but was that pretty much everyone that came to your show on Wednesday left with a piece of merch.
Yeah.
There was a constant stream of people. That's unheard of these days.
Oh, I don't even know. I've been out of the game so long. You know, once again, we, with our merch company, like, we're there's nobody in between us. Like, we have ideas, and we're like, what about this idea? And they're like, you know, 12 hours later, they're like, here's this idea. And they are excited that we're excited. It's really weird. A bunch of cool, like right now, we're doing this interview. We're in wherever, Chef, where are we? Donington.
Donington. Yeah. Right, yeah. Hello, Grand Donington.
Yeah. And Hollow Ground it is. And but there is nobody in the way of us, you know, like that guy right there, he's from Def Press, right? These guys are Ugly Kid Joe fans. When they heard we were doing this show, they got hold of us through Dan DeVita, our booking agent, right? And said, can we help them? And the answer to that, of course, is yes, please help us. So imagine all this, like a really awesome electrical charge conspiracy to help us that I can't really put into words, but something good's going on.
Yeah, something good is going on. We're going to have to wrap it up because I'm sure we all want to go and just catch a little bit of
That's
Megadeth.
Right. I do.
Right? You do. And but what's next?
We tour through July 8th. All right, now we do the Eastern Bloc. We go to Israel, which I've never been to, through music, rad. And then we go to Latin America in August, and then we come back here, right here in the UK with Alice Cooper, Main Support. What?
Nice, look forward to it. We'll have a great trip, and I'll catch up with you next time.
Awesome.